Yo. Top notch. Yo. Hey, yo. I know this shit gonna make motherfuckers go back and listen to this era of Wayne. This shit was cold.
That's when Wayne was Wayne.
Wayne. Weezy F, baby.
That nigga said Weezy F, baby, in the F for phenomenal.
Yo, this nigga killed this shit. Whatever, it's whatever. Yeah, I know I'm playing around too, a little too much, but I want to get Mary in there. Hey, way from yo. Showtime, hey yo, Swizzy. Yo, welcome on that bullshit podcast where anything can be and or will be bullshit in my book. Yo, I am feeling good, feeling great, feeling like a double XL freshman in this bitch. Hey yo, shout out my nigga Dizzy, man. That's my nigga. Yeah, I had to play Mary, man. Somebody's listening to me. Last year around this time, I said that the BET Awards was trash, it was whack, it was the worst, and I think that was the year they had Jamie hosting, I believe. It was trash, and I'm just like, really? Like,
it's been trash for a while.
It has been trash for a while, it really has. But at the same time, like, when that had dropped, I was like, yo, why aren't we, like, pushing the people that are alive for these awards? And Mary J. Blige, she was the one artist that I spoke on. And it's crazy that she got that award. It was well deserved. But the show she put on, oh my God. Oh my God. Now, me, personally, I'm a Mary fan. I don't see how anybody can hate on Mary. I had one person in my lifetime tell me that Mary J. Blige could not sing. And I respected it. But it was like, yo, Mary can't sing? And it was like, she can't sing, she can't hold a note. I'm like, it doesn't matter if she can sing, really. It's about the, like, when you hear Mary, it's the pain, it's the enjoyment. Like, they did a great job of breaking down Mary J. Blige on the BET Awards.
Yeah, I would never say that she can't sing. I feel like in certain parts when you watch her performance, that you see, like, okay, you can tell she's getting up there in age with her voice.
Yeah.
But she still can blow.
Yeah, she looks good, bro.
Oh, my. To be put, she pushing 50, and she bad.
She is bad, yo. Oh, my God. Yo.
Thick ass thighs with the, man, yo, man.
Oh, yeah,
you
bro.
Still single?
But, yo, yeah, the BET Awards, man, I did not watch it when it first aired. I did catch the performances, and then I did watch up until Mary's performance because I didn't care about anything else. And 9 times out of 10, I pretty much had just seen everything that I wanted to see. I just wanted to see where the awards went to. Once again, shout out Cardi. I felt like that was, like, a great award. I felt like the awards were perfect.
I didn't see who got any award. It was like a business meeting that turned into a kickback, and it happened, and it came on while we was chilling.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I was watching, but
I don't remember what the fuck. I think I literally just fell asleep.
But I'm gonna be honest, I did not like the Nipsey tribute.
Didn't get that far.
It was the very last thing before the one. Okay. I'm gonna say I didn't like it. It was just super short.
Okay.
It was mad short, and I was like, yo,
deserved more than yes. That. But at the same time, with it being short, I mean, look at what BET did for his funeral. You know what I'm saying? They not, I mean, like, they helped put that shit in LA. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't. And then again, I feel like with the family, they wouldn't want to keep.
The family was there.
I know they were there, but I'm saying, like, I don't know if anybody would have passed my shit. I just wouldn't want to keep looking it over and looking it over. I'm already dealing with it. You know what I'm saying?
No, I'm just saying, like, they did, I think, 3 performances. And they all did, like, verses, not songs.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I feel like, I think it would have been dope. Let's say, if they did last time I checked, the Snoop came out and did his verse. I think that would have been dope. But instead, YG came out there versus was over.
I feel you, but wouldn't they have to get some of those songs, what is it, like copyrighted or something? If they would have performed, for instance, him and Kendrick, Dedication?
Yeah, no, they already have, if they're already performing the song regardless of what part it was, because they come in with the hook already, so it's already they got clearance to do it.
Yeah. I mean... I didn't get that far.
From what I saw, that was my only real issue. Other than Cardi wasn't actually saying anything when she during her performance, she was
lip syncing. Like, I thought it was me too. So what performances did you like, or did you catch that you did like?
Okay, I did like Mary, of course.
Oh yeah, that's number one.
Offset.
Hey, yo, Offset, I'm not going to lie, out of all the Migos, everybody can speak on Quavo, but I'm a fan of...
I said what I said about Quavo last week, bro.
I'm actually becoming a fan of this dude's personality. There is rumors that this nigga's a clone.
I never heard that.
You ain't heard that after he got in the car accident? They was like, he wasn't... They say he was a clone. They said that after he got out of the car accident that he didn't make it out and they cloned him and all this other crazy shit that I just be into, man. Be into that weirdo.
No, I feel like out of all of the Migos, he does have the most personality.
Like, that motherfucker can dance, bro.
You don't know, like, it was a thing where, like, he was going through beef with somebody, I can't remember who it was, and they pulled up the video, an old video of him breakdancing and trying to use it against him. And
sounds like some Joe Budden shit.
The next video he came out with, next music video he came out with, he came out breakdown. He's like, bro, I can still do the shit. Like, I was like, yo, that's a good move. And then at the BET Awards, the first time on a public stage, he did that.
Hey, yo, I want to see that nigga.
And out of the three,
Chris Brown, bro.
Out of the three Migos, he's definitely the best. He had the best solo album.
Yeah, we're going to get into albums. We did promise them that we were going to talk about albums that dropped halfway throughout the year and how we feel about the albums and where we rank. What do you want to do, 3 or 5?
We can do top 3.
All right. Before we get off the BET Awards, I don't think as much as we feel DaBaby is pushing for North Carolina, I don't think it's reaching that out there. Because I say that as I watch his performance, nobody was really rocking to his performance like other people have in, let's say, Atlanta or here. No,
I felt that way when I watched it, and then I saw something today. I saw his behind the scenes of leading up to his performance.
Oh, that shit was cold. Love that shit. I enjoyed his performance.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, he had the behind the scenes he put on YouTube. Like everything leading up to the performance and after the performance.
Oh, I thought you was talking about like when they came out with the Snoop Dogg and fucking Suge Knight shit.
Oh, no.
Shit was cold. No, that shit was cold.
So like when you watch his shit, first of all, you see how many people already in the industry have fucked with him. With the Migos and T.I. coming up, like you see how many people in the industry fuck with him already.
Okay.
But then also like when you see like other camera shots, there's actually a crowd on the side of the stage. They rocking.
Okay, got you.
They rocking the whole time.
I did like what's her name? The host. Who was it? What was her name?
Regina Hall.
Yeah, Regina. I felt like she did okay. I feel like we gotta do better at selecting the hosts.
I liked her.
I like the fact that she brought the go-go. Yeah. I love that
shit. Before we keep going, I do want to speak something else on DaBaby's performance.
What?
I feel like he should have had a longer set. Because I know Suge is his big song right now.
Yeah.
But yeah, he came out with that. But I feel like with who was in the room and who also performed, bro, he has a song with Offset. Why do not bring Offset out? He's on a song with YG, why not bring YG?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So I just felt like, and then also, you know, before the BET Awards, YG just brought DaBaby out on the set. So I was like, why not let him do that? He put together a whole theatrical thing to do one song.
It's like, I like that nigga's energy, bro. I do. Like, hopping out in the crowd, I like that energy. I'm gonna tell you, I don't like that fucking song. Lil Nas X. Can't stand that fucking song.
He just dropped his EP.
And the EP is 7 songs, and I listened to them all. And really, the only song that I like is the one with Cardi B.
That bitch fire, but I did not want Cardi on that song. Nope, I don't like it.
I can really, really, really can't remember her verse, but the beat on that shit was hard. I did like
it. Beat
that.
Was hard.
Yeah.
But I felt like for the image of Lil Nas X and that song, should have had Megan Thee Stallion on it instead of Cardi.
And
then Cardi, I
can see
like,
it.
I felt like her words were kind of jumping.
But
a
they're bit. Trying to give this kid that push. So
why I get it. I completely get it.
It was definitely.
It was a marketing move in a.
What else did
move.
He have up there? He had somebody else featuring. I can't remember. It wasn't a good EP. It wasn't a good EP. That shit was trash. If I had to label it, it was trash.
I didn't listen to it all the way through. I did see Twitter. A lot of people on Twitter hyping it up, saying it was good.
But it was, I mean.
I guess it depends on what you're looking for, maybe.
I was literally looking to see if he was going to be a one-hit wonder. Do I feel that way? Yes and no. You can tell he's not a rapper or he's just he's an entertainer. That's what it is. But his performance.
That's where I beg to differ. Because if you go back and listen to anything he had before the country shit.
Yeah.
He was rapping.
Oh, well, when I say like rap, I mean like somebody needs to write for this nigga.
I don't think so.
On this 7-song EP?
No, because they doing the country shit.
Okay.
Because that, like, he did the one song.
Travis Barker was who I'm thinking of. That shit was trash. I was actually hyped to hear that shit, but you can tell, like, it was more of a rock song. It wasn't even, like, it was.
But he had said, when Old Town Road first started blowing up, he debuted a rock song. He was like, yeah, I'm taking over rock next. He's just trying to be the guy that has a song in every genre.
That's cool.
But, like, I mean, I think it'll be dope if everyone, let's say you put out a song in different genres and they all chart on them genres. Because, you know, Old Town Road, of course, it went up on our side.
Yeah.
There was a whole debacle about it being on the country side.
Yeah.
But, like, I think it'll be dope because if he pulls it off the way he wants to, that's a record right there. Ain't nobody in hip hop did that. In every genre? Have a song on the chart of every genre?
Yeah, ain't nobody done that. But Nelly still got the best goddamn country song.
Oh, over and over again.
Hey, that shit cold. Nelly, I will say this. Billy Ray Cyrus, I was shocked. Not necessarily shocked, but I just wanted to see his manner and how he handled himself around, like, yeah, you know what I'm saying, a bunch of black people.
But they say he went to an HBCU, though.
And that's what shocked me, too.
I didn't know that.
This nigga's a nigga.
And then when she said, he was like, he was with it.
I was like, all right, bet. So he could come to the cookout. But that nigga
Molly got to stay home,
was also lip singing, too.
Molly got to stay at home.
It's funny, speaking of the BET Awards, Miley, I wanted to touch on, fuck. Fucking nose ring, man. Damn, that hurt. Mm. Yeah, that shit hurt like hell. Got me tearing up. Shit. YouTube, don't mind me. What was I saying?
Miley.
God damn. Miley Cyrus, Nicki Minaj. Okay, yeah. That's what I want to get into. Nicki's situation, man. The homie brought it to my attention and he was like, yo, Nicki was going in on Queen Radio, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, why? Like, what is she bitching about now? And it's crazy how everything comes together and lead up because BET had the worst records or ratings for the BET Awards. They had 2 million views. And she had made a statement, put out a tweet saying, like, just some other shit. I got the tweet right here, but I really don't feel like reading it. Anywho, she was beefing with Miley Cyrus, what, about 3 years ago? What was that, the MTV?
MTV Music Awards.
MTV Music Awards. Miley was hosting, I believe. And something down the line came through where they just had a beef. And
which, honestly, I feel like Nicki Minaj was like, I feel like Nicki Minaj is a bitch, bro. Like, no, I'm just, no, I say that in the, not like, yeah. That's her being a female.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, if a nigga do some bitch shit, it's some bitch shit. She get on the MTV shit, Molly was good, trying to be on some hood shit, knowing, nobody about, you're not about to touch her.
Exactly. But
where was that energy when Cardi was at your ass?
When Kim was at your ass.
Yeah, facts.
When
Remy.
Exactly. Like,
you do that for the little young white girl.
That knows she not gonna do shit. So at the same time, it's like, you pick and choosing your fight. So with that statement that you just made, I don't want to hear her bitching and complaining or throwing out statements about what Miley did to such and such.
But I did see the reason that she brought it up, because Miley had an interview talking about she listened to hip-hop. She was like, oh, I like Nicki regardless of what happened in the past, but I listen to Cardi.
I mean, I do too. Like, yo, let's be real. We're not going to sit here and act like Nicki was not the shit when she was holding shit down for hip-hop. She was doing it. So, yes, her legacy is solidified. But you coming out like a little hoe-ass nigga right now, like, yo, shut up. Certain shit don't need to be said.
I feel like...
You bitching about something that happened 3 years ago.
I feel like the best thing for Nicki to do...
is go act.
Is to stay off of social everything. Radio, social media, all that shit. And rap. Not pop shit.
Rap.
And go back in the lab with Wayne.
Do we really want that? Like, with all the antics and all the bullshit that Nicki is doing, do we really want that? Like,
if she came back out rapping with something fire, is undeniable. So let's say if she, after all the bullshit she's done now, and she comes with another monster verse. It's undeniable.
Hey, yo, Nicki was tearing shit up around that age.
So I'm saying, like, it will be undeniable. You're like, okay, yo, she in her bag. Also, with that being said, that will give her everything that she's trying to get right now. That's going to give her the looks again that she's trying to get. People going to be looking at her like, oh, and we know she wrote it. That puts her over Cardi. Because that's what she wants right now.
Exactly. I mean,
it's going to give her everything that she wants.
I just, me personally, I'm Young Money, besides Wayne, has really let, I feel, hip-hop down. Because at that time, when Young Money was running shit, when they was over MMG, when they was over Good Music, when they was over, like, half the industry, like, they wanted to be solidified or part of Young Money. At the end of the day, it's like, they, to me, that is the biggest letdown group in hip-hop. They had... Now, money-wise, yes, they succeeded. But hip-hop, rapping, bar for bar, tearing the streets up, they're letting it down. They not holding their own.
I feel like...
And everybody can speak on Drake, but at the end of the day, Drake...
Drake is not putting on Young Money, he's putting on OVO.
Exactly. So, like, that nigga has transferred over to another team. He not focused on y'all.
Like, he like, yo, y'all got me here? I'm going to build my own team now. Like, pretty much like when Wayne did, when Cash Money got on where it needed to be, Wayne made Young Money. Only thing is, he put both of them on his back.
Exactly.
Drake, like, yo, y'all got me in, now I got my own team. Peace. Like, I was actually talking to one of my coworkers. He was like, yo, I was surprised that when Drake put out the album, Wayne went on it. And then when Wayne put out the album, Drake went on it. I was like, niggas is doing their own shit.
I mean, I respect the grind, but...
But, I mean, even Tyga had Wayne on his album.
But see, I'm actually championing Tyga right now. Because out of all them, Tyga is the only one that's really, like, sticking to his roots.
Oh, and then he
that's what it is with me. It's just sticking to the roots.
I feel like as much people clown Tyga or whatever, I think he's about to really have a run. Because
is it because he's really? I mean, I know he's throughout his career he's been fucking with the West Coast niggas, but
he is West Coast.
I mean, yeah, but I'm saying when I first heard Tyga, it was on that damn put the lime in the coconut and twist it all up.
Right.
Trash.
That remix was fire.
Remix was fire, but that shit I did not like it. I'm like, who the fuck is this dude?
See, here's the thing. The crazy thing is that was the first thing I heard too. I was like, I wasn't with it, and then Travis McCoy, Gym Class Heroes.
Yep.
they're cousins.
Yeah.
And not her, you know, I listen to Travis McCoy. And I know I was like just watching the interview, talking about that. And he's like big in Tiger Up. And at the time, this is maybe 08 or some shit.
Yeah.
So I want to go dig into his mixtapes. And bro raps.
He can, yes, the nigga can, yo, Tiger can fucking rap. Like I said, we had Mario up here, and that motherfucker will tell you probably every fucking song, boom, 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 from top to bottom.
Bro, bro, it was a time when I was in high school, I want to say maybe 09, 10, mm-hmm. me and my homie Eddie, White Eddie. White Eddie. We called him Albino Eddie because like, he was black, but he was white. Albino Eddie. We were the only Tiger fans. We was like, yo, I don't care what y'all talking about. Bro, be going. Bro, be going. And but I feel like right now, once he got back in his back, like people started paying attention to him. Because he dropped a project right after he was done with Kylie. And I personally feel like he got a couple hits on it.
But what was that? The Last King or some shit?
No, that wasn't. Last King was the first album.
Well, no. Well, like, no, he did the run with Chris Brown.
Right.
Fan of a Fan.
Two, yeah.
One and two. And then.
One was in high school. Two was when he was with Kylie. Yeah, trying to get that nigga popping.
And then there was another joint that he did. I can't remember the name of that damn album.
He had the Gold album, which in all honesty was trash. He fit the whole album dissing Drake. Trash. He had another one last year. I can't remember the name of it. But that shit sounded like an R&B album, bro. I was singing on it.
Certain shit, like, he needs to just stick to the strip club shit. But I think that's his lane.
He had another joint called Bitch on the Shit 3. He made it an album, but it was like the third one out of a series he had been doing. And on that shit, he had a song with Ty Dolla $ign that I was like, yo, that shit should have been going. It should have been out of here. But niggas wasn't
pushing
him. They wasn't paying him no attention at the time. But then he comes with Taste, the joint with Offset. That was motherfucking beat.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. That shit.
You heard Joe Budden do that shit. Like, that shit, everywhere. He drops that shit. He drops another one that sounds just like it. That's what Tiger do now. And then he dropped a song with Nicki Minaj. They didn't even like each other for a minute.
Yeah.
I feel like Nicki's trying to heat back up. He's heating back up. That's old Young Money. Why not?
Just get into it. They just need to either get back that chemistry or everybody need to just go on about their way.
Yeah. But like that song did okay. I feel like I think there was a disconnect somewhere where they didn't push it as hard as
they should. We also got to remember that he went through his legal shit with Birdman.
Right.
But
you know, this is after though, because he was like, he pretty much paid Birdman to get out of his contract, even though they owe him money.
Yeah. I mean, I'm liking Tiger's wave. I'm liking Tiger's moves right now.
Did you listen to his album?
I did listen to his album. Like I said, we're definitely going to get into albums. The thing is, we'll get into albums.
I think he's about to do a run. He's had a couple of hits. If niggas don't know, he's the one that made the hook for Go Loco.
Did you listen to fucking On God? DJ Mustard shit. DJ Mustard dropping, I believe, Friday.
I did not.
Yo. Oh my God. It's YG, Ferg, Rocky, and then they dropped the beat, slowed it down, and Tiger rapped on it. I ain't know how I felt about that, but the beat go hard, and YG spazzed on that shit. So I fuck with it. I'm ready for Mustard album tomorrow.
You know what? I will be okay. I kind of don't know how I feel about certain joint albums. If Tiger, Chris, and YG did some shit, like a little 5 to 7 song EP, ooh, that shit could be crazy.
I'm sorry. I'm not taking Chris on that. You gotta stay West Coast 100, bro. You gotta put
dollar sign. I can see that too.
Dollar sign, YG, and fucking Tiger.
The only reason I said Chris is because Chris and Tiger have a good chemistry.
And this is off topic, but chemistry, because we rock with Jordan Lucas.
Mm-hmm.
Jordan Lucas, I feel, is not getting that push. And I don't know why, because Jordan Lucas has multiple songs with Chris Brown, and they don't pop, they don't do anything, and them songs be actually fire. And it's like, why can Tiger get this and like You know what I'm saying? Why can't Joyner get it?
For the masses, Tyga and Chris Brown is easier to listen to.
But let
me say this.
Okay.
Because when they did their first song together, Joyner and Chris, can't think of the name of the song right now.
Brain fart.
anyway, I was bumping that shit, and I took it to my cousin's crib. This is when I was staying in Philly. Her and her friends are all super big Chris Brown fans. They love Chris Brown. Anything that he on. I played a song. They're like, I like Chris part. I don't know how I feel about the rest. And I was like, damn, really? Like, bro, because he killing that shit. He's like, yeah, but I can't understand nothing he's saying. I think that's the biggest thing is most people, because for lit songs, people want to be able to sing the song. You can't sing alone to Jordan Lucas.
You can't. That nigga bring that super duper speed. What else do we have on the shit? What else? Shit. Where did we get off track at? We were talking about Nicki and we were talking about Young Money and
like turn the Tyga.
Yeah.
Then YG and
yeah.
Man, we just be talking.
We doing on that bullshit. Damn, that was a good conversation. I can't remember what we were talking about. Fuck it. What else were we about to get into today? Okay. The game went on
crazy.
Oh my god, yo,
crazy.
I think that's where we're gonna go with this. After. All right, boom.
Crazy. That nigga was crazy.
The game is so underrated to me.
Yes. Yes.
Now, no lie, I know niggas listening to this gonna be like, yo, you crazy, how you gonna fuck with the West Coast like that and not know this? Why do I only feel like the game got like 4 or 5 albums? This nigga is about to drop his 10th album. Yeah. When he said that in the fucking interview, I'm like, bullshit. No, because I'm gonna tell you the albums that I know. You got Documentary, you got Documentary 2, you got 1992, and then you got...
There's a gap right
there. I know it's a big gap, but I can't think of the name of the album.
Like, Doctor's Advocate, Red.
That was the fifth one. Red.
Nigga, that...
No, I'm trying to think, because I'm getting confused with YG now. Like, the Red, like, it's just Red?
Yeah, that's the name of the album.
Because YG got a Red album. So, that's what I'm saying. It's a lot of shit.
You go to the Red album, got one of the... One of the hardest Kendrick verses ever, bro. Nigga.
Yo, I'm still, like, lost. And, like, I even went online. I'm like, yo, this nigga does have 9 albums. But ain't no damn way I was about to go back and
listen. I was surprised you know 1992.
You surprised I know it?
Yeah.
Didn't he diss Meek on that shit?
But I'm like, you know that, I'm gonna say you knew that one, but couldn't think of Doctor's Advocate?
No, I remember.
Or you don't know, but you don't know Red. Like, that's
I don't know. Yeah.
Red was his, I believe... His final album before getting off the last label he was on, so he dropped 2 albums independent before getting back on the label,
and that's probably why, because he was independent and right. He wasn't like let me ask you this: when he went independent, was it still in mixtape era?
No, that
so was, that's what I'm saying. Like
no, that when, that was I would say when Bobby Shmurda was popping. That was about maybe.
How far along was it? Was it before Documentary 2? Because it took a minute for Documentary 2 to drop.
Yeah,
and then he dropped the Documentary 2.5.
Yeah, it was before Documentary.
Okay, like I said, when I was listening to the interview, I'm like, nigga, you lying. You ain't got fucking 9 albums. And you talking about you about to drop 10? So that's just me having the lack of the game. But everything that I've listened to from the game has been fire. Yeah, this nigga.
He got two albums. I can't remember. The first one was called Year of the Wolf. I can't think of the second one. But the second one, because he had a lot of artists that he was trying to help put on in the West Coast, and he was putting those two independent albums he had was him doing that. And he was like trying to help like new artists. Like he got Bobby Shmurda all over that motherfucker.
He
got,
was
like,
bigging up Don Q. Don Q. Kenny does the same nigga, right?
No,
there's two niggas. Okay, because my barber keep telling me to listen to Dom.
Don Q and Dom Kennedy.
Okay, it's two different niggas. All right,
Don Q is the New York nigga.
And that nigga don't rap on beat, right?
That's it, why he's the dude. Remember, I told you, I was like, yo, kind of remind me of Styles P.
And I told you, I was just like, yo, he can rap, but he just don't rap on beat, and I can't listen to him. So when he made the statement, I'm like, that nigga don't rap on beat. So why, like, not why are you giving this nigga a push? But I understood where he was coming from. But thanks for letting me know that I need to go listen to
Dom Kennedy.
Dom Kennedy.
And then he's been out for a while.
Yeah, like, I mean, I heard him before.
But, like, he like that.
That nigga said he like the Ice Cube. I'm like, nigga, Cube in my top five, nigga. Well, nah, he my top 10.
I'm about to go back and listen to it. We'll bring it back next week.
But
Don Q, his freestyles to me are better because, like, you hear, like, I don't know. I think he's more on beat when he freestyles, which is weird.
And who is that? Yeah, hold on.
Don Q. He's from New York. He's part of A Boogie with the Hoodie Squad.
Man, all I know is my barber kept telling me to listen to that nigga, and I would listen to him, and it was just like I could not get with it because he won't rapping on beat.
To me, like, if you put, cause I feel the same way about Styles P. He don't always rap on beat.
Not always, but yeah. Like when you listen to Styles P, it's not you're listening for his bars, you're listening for his story.
But that's why I listen to Don Q.
Okay, all right.
But I think remind me of Styles P the way he raps, like flow wise and how you approach it, and then. A lot of times, subject matter, he reminds me of Pusha T.
Okay. Back to the game, though, man. That fucking... spitting, man, yo, time out.
First of all...
A nigga really freestyling?
And then, when he... I don't think all of it was a freestyle.
Not all of it.
Because that Prodigy...
That little name flip shit?
That Prodigy verse, that shit came out the sleeve, bro. He had it. Yo, he ain't just
had spitting bars on but that.
But then,
shit.
And I don't know. I could be wrong. I don't know if he just had that Go Loco and then the cut. Like, not the beginning.
I'm gonna tell you this.
When he was spitting in Spanish.
Yeah, I don't know what he was saying in Spanish, but that shit sounded hard.
It was hard.
But yo, that nigga Old Town Road.
That shit was hard.
My God,
I think that was one of your freestyles, and that shit was hard.
That shit was.
But the crazy thing was, like, when the beat came on, I was like, I feel like
he's about to.
No, I was like, take my push to. I like, and then he said, like, I knew that's what he was gonna say. I knew it, bro. But then, he killed that shit.
He put that West Coast style. Oh my, yo, I need that. I'm sorry, I need that.
Oh yeah, I thought, bro. I went and watched the comments. I was looking at the comments. I was like, yo. Can you put that on wax?
Oh, God. And that's why I brought this up. That's why I brought this up, because we really missed that era.
Which is crazy. If he do, he got to do it with YG. Because YG has a slight freestyle that he kind of did on, I think it was Big Boy, with Old Town Road. He's like, I'm going to take my Lambo. Like, I feel like they got to do it together.
Yo, I would, like, I'm in love with the West Coast. Like, I just love everything about it. And it's crazy. But that sound is just crazy, man. It's fucking fire. At the same time, that's the era that I miss. It's like, you remember when niggas dropped the freestyle. You went to LimeWire. And you couldn't get, the first time you searched for a freestyle, you couldn't get the freestyle that you was looking for. So you had another nigga verse on the same beat. And you had brought this up before that, at that point in time, you just literally had your MP3 player. This was before the fucking the iPod.
Yeah,
before all that shit. So that was just fun.
Yeah, with all
and
the fucking
to the pornos and shit.
Where the fucking the title would have been Old Underscore Town Underscore MP3 Dot Wave.
That was the fucking era that I like when it came down to just. That's when I fuck with technology and computers. Yo, once they got rid of all that shit, I was just like, yo, I'm done with all this shit.
I remember, bro. This is just mad change right here.
Oh, no. I was like, bro, hold on, chill out, bro.
I remember, you remember the old neighborhood I used to live in? Everybody in that neighborhood knew me for having CDs where I have 1,000 remixes to the same song on one CD.
Can I tell you some funny shit? When I was watching the freestyle, that's what made me be like, yo, I have to bring like this whole shit up of just having fun of just hopping on LimeWire. The funny thing is, you talking about CDs, yes, sir, and you want to know some crazy shit. I want to know if you fuck with me like I fuck with you, Pause. Anywho, dog, you made all of my blank CDs. You made all the shits. And then you went back to Philly and you doing your thing. You came back. and you hooked up my fucking flash drive.
Oh, yeah.
That was just crazy to me. It's like, yo.
Put all the Disney nigga, on it. Yo, put all of, yo,
yo, you are that nigga. I was like, bro, yeah, bro, I don't fuck with goddamn technology no more. Can you, I said, bro, I can give you a flash drive. Well, nah, he was like, bro, you got a USB? I'm like, fuck is a USB? I'm like, he was like, bro, flash drive. I'm like, yeah, nigga, I got that shit. It's in the car. And, yo, that shit's crazy. We've been rocking
for I've always been the nigga with the music, bro.
Yes, bro. But just sitting back, you can hear several niggas' verses from just freestyles to from Rap City in the Basement to 106 to niggas from 106 Freestyle Friday. You take they verse, and then you have a nigga that blended. Like, yo, that was the fucking era, bro.
I was 13 when I started doing that. I started blending that shit. Yo, when I learned how to do that, it was a wrap.
I was like, yo, I missed this shit. And it felt good to actually have a vet like the Game go up there. And I feel like it needs to be more vets to go.
Like, I know he got an album coming up, but I feel like he went up there specifically to rap. Because he went up there and he said, shout out Megan Thee Stallion and the Baby. Those are the two dopest ones I've seen lately. And yes. He started rapping.
Yes, bro.
I think he went up there to prove that. Yeah, because the name of the album is Born to Rap.
Yes,
he
bro.
Went up there for that.
That West Side, that single.
I'm ready for the video. Have you seen the clip they doing?
Yes, bro. They trying to do that California Love, but I don't see how. Only because that beat don't ride.
No, it's, like, I don't know, man. He got Dave East in that motherfucker. What's my man?
Esquire.
Yep. That's what I was talking about.
Time out. I hate to cut and stop talking this shit, but I feel like this is another conversation that needs to be brought up here. I bring up Esquire because I was out on a Tuesday.
Johnny Long, that's really something.
I don't know that nigga name. Esquire.
You had a whole phone here.
Man, I don't want to accidentally press something and that shit just start playing music. But anyways, Esquire. And I bring that up because I was out Tuesday. I was out. Like, I wasn't in the crib. I was out. You know, I'm normally in the crib. So, any motherfuckers that keep saying I'm in the crib and I ain't gonna leave this motherfucker, y'all lying, y'all bugging, you just gotta hit me.
First of all, he's only saying that because I just said it before. Somebody was like, yo, tell Press to come do the podcast over here. Because I was somewhere else with a whole other type of situation we ain't gonna get into right now. But, I was like, that nigga not leaving the house.
Anywho, I was out Tuesday, and motherfuckers was quoting, what's the name of it, ATL, or is it, yeah, it's ATL. ATL. They were quoting ATL, and of course, I know what they saying, they quoting, and I'm like, y'all so trash. They like, what, yo, I'm like, bro, that movie's not a fucking classic. Out of all the black movies that we got, that shit is trash. ATL is trash, bro, it's trash. That and Roll Bounce is trash. Shout out my niggas that's in Atlanta that actually listen. I got a few. And I don't want to disrespect.
I'm going to be honest, bro.
I'll never say that in Atlanta. But their movies are trash. Roll Bounce and fucking ATL, both of them, which is ass better, bro?
ATL is a classic, bro.
That's not a classic, bro. Is. Why? Because you can quote it?
No.
When the last time you popped it in?
That is a classic.
That shit not a classic. That shit is trash.
Listen, bro. Because classics, to us, are older movies. Oh, like, you know, the Fridays and shit like that.
Fridays.
The Dead Press.
Bro. The Wood.
But here's the thing. The generation that's after us, that is a classic for them.
I get what you're saying, but I tell them youngins.
And I'm going to be honest. I fuck with Roll Bounce, but that is not a classic movie.
It's not. It's not. But Roll Bounce is better than ATL.
No, the fuck it ain't.
Yeah, it is.
No, it ain't.
Both of them shits was trash.
No, bro, you nigga, what the fuck is you on? Stop smoking whatever the fuck is in that shit.
I'm not even bullshitting, yo. Like, that movie comes on, I'm like, you know, like when you had a cookout and they got a movie on, that's not the movie that's on. And if somebody say put that shit in, niggas is leaving.
No.
Nobody gives a fuck about Nunu.
I disagree wholeheartedly.
Yo,
wholeheartedly. No.
Man, okay, if we sat back and just gave out a list of movies that we consider classic, I'm not going to say, like, boy, I can say Boys in the Hood and be like, which is better? Like, come on. We already know Boys in the Hood. We can go Men's Society. We can go to Wood. all these movies that I'm naming are better than ATL.
But listen to the ice to the age of when shit came out.
I get what you're saying.
Because, nigga, John Singleton didn't do ATL, nigga. If he did, it'll be a different conversation.
That movie's trash. It's trash.
Next subject.
No,
moving on.
No, back to the game and niggas freestyling. My nigga Lil Dicky did a freestyle. I want music from Lil Dicky.
Did you hear his last single? I ain't like it.
Hold on, you talking about the shit with Chris Brown?
No, he has another one.
Oh, you talking about the Earth shit? Yeah, I did hear that. Like, but no lie, the only reason that I liked it and I may be giving him a pass is because I feel like
I get why he did it and I understand it. That's cool. Sonically as a song, I don't like it.
I mean, I feel like that song is literally the up and coming. Well, since you want to do eras and shit, I feel like with this new era of shit, that is the new era of We Are the World.
I knew you was gonna say that shit.
Am I wrong?
I can see it.
Tell me. Speaking of We Are the World, you remember what was that 2001 where they had
Michael Jackson?
No. I think Diddy had something to do with that shit. Yo, it had so many niggas on that shit. It had Wyclef. Talking about, and I think that's the first time we heard Wayne sing on the song. We are the world. it had Pink up there. It had Justin Timberlake. It had Nelly. It had Lil' Kim. It had Alicia Keys. And them motherfuckers were ripping off the headbands and shit. Yo, tell me you do, like, you do not remember that shit?
Hell no, that don't even sound like I want parts of that shit.
Yo, it was so many niggas.
No, I don't want no parts of that
shit. I want to say T-Pain was on it. Yo, it was so many niggas on that shit, and it was a disaster. That shit was horrible.
I do want to say, because I made this statement before, that Wayne is the father of mumble rap. And I say, I know the verse to me that birthed mumble rap is Can't Believe It.
Yep.
The birth mumble rap in that verse. Yes, fire
yes,
verse.
Yes. You know, they said that, like, I remember it like it was yesterday. I was listening to
what the fuck
to
he said?
It was a big-ass controversy because they were like, the song is good, but you don't know what Wayne is saying because he was so hot. And, like,
and I know every word of that verse now.
I mean, they had to go back and get it because it was, the original shit was so fucked up. That niggas had to like, do you remember it? Like, spit it real quick. Give me
I got
something.
To tell you with the song.
Yeah.
I'm not,
that shit was just.
But, like, I feel like that verse is what birthed Young Thug and the Lil Uzi and all these other little motherfuckers who don't talk.
Speaking of little, pause. Go back to Lil Dicky. How did you feel about his freestyle and what do you expect or what do you want from?
What I want from Dicky, I'm not gonna get from Dicky, cause he has a new TV show coming.
Yeah, and I seen Kale up there. Is he part of Sway's radio show, or is he gonna be on the show?
He was up there. I think his interview was before Dicky's.
Okay,
so he was still there.
And I know Kale has done a lot of things. He's done a lot of producing.
He's producing the All That reboot.
Well, yeah, he's doing that. But I know he did literally producing like music. For Lady Gaga, I know he did that.
Oh, you tell me something, I don't know.
Yeah, nah, he's like, throughout that whole time of what's going on with King and Kel and all this shit, they were just like, he's stepping away from the scene, from the screen to actually produce.
I don't know. I know that nigga went broke at one point, bro. I don't know.
That may be true, too.
It's very true. He lost some money, he lost his wife, he lost a lot of shit.
Damn.
Sorry. Ah. Sorry, kid. Hey, go. Nigga, they gonna know. If you don't know, Kid and the Kid, go watch it.
Yeah, classic.
Definitely, bro. I was here thinking. You realize that Keenan, his whole career has been sketch comedy. Yeah. From all of that, the Kid in the Cam, straight to SNL.
SNL, and he's getting, ABC gave him his own show, so I'm ready.
He did.
I'm ready to see that, and I don't watch a lot of shit. Like, I didn't watch Blackish on that shit.
I didn't either.
But I'm definitely going to tune into that. I think it's going to be dope.
I mean, other than, I think, Good Burger and the Fat Albert movie, this nigga's never actually really done...
Yeah, much shit.
Script, like, something fully scripted like that.
Oh, hell. Oh, whoa, time off. We disrespecting that homie. We forgot this nigga played in the Mighty Ducks. We forgot that this nigga played in Fat Camp. Oh, no, wait.
What's the other joint?
Yeah, let's not forget this nigga's been in a lot of shit.
Barbershop 3?
Yeah, did he play in 2 and 3?
Oh, the 2 or 3?
2 and 3. Because the motherfucker... Hey, yo, that motherfucker, he went over and crossed over to the other barber shop.
Yeah.
And that motherfucker was cut.
excuse me. I think it's, like, I've never thought him as an adult was that funny until I go back and watch him, bro.
Yeah, like, yo,
I always thought he was like...
But that's everything, though.
I thought he had corny jokes. But then I was like, yo, he's actually kind of funny.
He is, man.
California to me.
Damn. Let's get into this album shit, cause I know you pressed and you gotta do your thing and everything. You the busiest nigga I know, bro.
Thank you.
That's not a diss. That's
I said thank you.
Yeah, like
I posted it on Instagram earlier today. The nigga say he grind harder than us. He either part of the team or he lying.
I know a lot of liars. my bad, damn. Forgetting we on the shit, bro, for real. I done got into the goddamn Kingdom Cash shit. Alright, so we are halfway through the year, and we have a few albums. Me personally,
I want to say, before we get into it, let's start from October to now. Because I feel like
because you want to mention me.
Because I feel like a lot of shit get washed over. Okay. The Grammys do September to September.
Yeah.
So I was like, let's
do October. Okay. All right. So
for me,
let's run down the albums that have dropped this year. I'm gonna give you the phone. But so we're speaking of October. So let's see if you can get that. The way we gonna do this, man, we just gonna, you know what I'm saying, talk about the albums that have dropped, and we just gonna come to a conclusion on pretty much, I guess, 5 albums. And then after that, before we get out of here, we gonna speak on the albums that we know are coming and what we expect from them. While Poe was looking that shit up,
I wanna say just all of some shit that I'm seeing right now. For like FM from Vince Staples got washed over.
Okay.
That,
wasn't that way last year?
Hey, that was last year, but I was just I just want to throw that out there.
Okay. Because we had spoke about him on Up in Smokes.
You did.
Let's start from Meek on. Okay. What was that? Hold on. Did Drake drop then too?
Drake was a little earlier.
No, we talked about Drake. So let's talk about Meek, because we did not talk about the champion.
Next, Oxnard, Anderson .Paak, his album.
Okay. Okay.
That shit definitely should be spoken about.
That joint was good. Anderson .Paak, man, definitely is underrated talent, bro. I feel he does not get the recognition that he deserves. And it's crazy because he signed a Dre, right? He signed a Aftermath.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's crazy. I was thinking when I was watching the Dr. Dre, the fucking The Game interview, that everybody that Dr. Dre fucks with or signs, they are just phenomenal and instant legends. Instant.
I'm about to say, the only person who didn't blow with him, they left and kind of blew later, was Eve.
And I don't think that was his fault.
I mean,
at the same time,
the way she explained it was like, they was rocking and then he found him and was like, all about that.
Yeah, and that makes sense. But I don't think Eve would have strived or been as successful as she was.
No, she just like Rough Riders was her home. That was
definitely dope.
That was good for her. I think Dom Trap was washed over.
What was that?
That was T.I.'s album. It was pretty good.
Was that the one with Dave Chappelle?
Yeah.
I did not like that album. The only thing I did like about it was Dave Chappelle. My thing is this, man. I don't like T.I. doing the route of Jay-Z doing the 444 thing. That's how I looked at it. That's how I compared that album. And my
I like it better than 444.
Well, see, me, I don't dislike 444. I appreciate what it is, but I was already on that level of what 444 was. You know what I'm saying? I brought my crib. I was focused. You know what I'm saying? I was on what Jay was talking about on that album. So, me, I just looked at it as, all right, great, boom.
Let's not watch over Young Sinatra.
Oh, nah. We definitely not going to do that. Young Sinatra was definitely dope. And I don't know why everybody's, like, dissing Logic because of the Everybody album. Everybody album.
I hated that fucking album.
But it was a concept album, but I felt all everybody
albums,
hated
all,
it.
All of his albums are concept albums.
But that album I felt nobody really fucked with, only because he kept referencing the black and white
and
shit.
No, he's been doing that, since the album, he's been doing that nonstop, which has kind of turned me off from being a fan.
And
I know he can rap.
I agree with you, but this goes back to what Eminem has said. Eminem said in a song, I can't quote it right word for word, but pretty much what I got from it was, as a hip-hop artist, as a motherfucker that's on that level, when people put you up to that pedestal, and it's like, once you write that first line or that one song that puts you up top,
you try to remake it.
And that's what Logic done. I'm actually realizing it too, that I'm catching on to what he's saying. Because he'll say some shit like, I'm back at it like an asthmatic. I mean, like goddamn. Yeah.
But
yeah, fucked it up.
But I like, because early Logic, he's still low-key said he was black and white. Yes. I remember him saying, he didn't say nothing about his skin or what he actually was. He said that lyrically, I'm on the same scale as Cole and Drizzy. But he said lyrically, but not, y'all, you know, Drake and Cole are
both
mixed.
Biracial, yeah.
I was like, that was him low-key saying that. I liked it when he did that shit. The fact that I'm white as such and such, and black as my cousin Keisha. Man, we don't even know Keisha.
Yeah. But definitely, man. But that album was fucking fire. That was the one with the Wu-Tang.
Yeah.
Yo, my favorite song up there, which I don't diss Wale. I just don't feel Wale pushes himself to the standard that he should.
I just tweeted yesterday. I get bothered when niggas talk about top tier rappers and Wale is left out. They slight him. And honestly, that was my most retweeted tweet I've ever had.
And we can beef about that right now, because you have to put in the effort to be on the court.
He dropped so... Bro, last year, this nigga dropped like 4 EPs.
Yes, and they were... Well, come on, how much you gonna give them credit? They were 3 songs. Come on.
So...
But they were
good songs.
So 3-6. So he had 9 songs last year. And what did they do?
And he drops more. He drops shit. But everybody's digging up Megan Thee Stallion right now. Wale brought her out first on one of his songs.
Hey yo, I guess I really pushed the button. That's the loudest you've ever been on this shit. But yo, my thing is, I don't dislike Wale. I did not like him signing to MMG. That's what turned me off. That was not a good career move for him. You do not need to go sign with that. That's not you.
I don't think it was a bad career move, because it worked for a time.
What? At a time where MGM? Yeah. MGM. God, yo, I'm fucking up. MGM. Fucking
MMG.
MMG. God damn, yo. I'm thinking of the... I'm tripping. MMG. At that time, Young Money was unstoppable. Not saying he should have signed there. Who was he signed to when he was dropping Pretty Girls? Not Pretty
Atlantic.
Girls.
Atlantic.
Yo, at the end of the day, he could have been their best.
He had an issue with Atlantic, and so he was like, okay, it's time for me to part ways. I feel like when he first went to Ross, his first 2 albums over there, he was good.
I'll give you one. What was the one with the...
He had Ambition and Gifted. Those are the first 2 he did over there. I feel like those...
Ambition was the one that I was thinking of.
Yeah, that one's a great album.
Yes. But after that...
He still had good albums. They just weren't pushed.
And I mean, I'm not going to keep giving this dude excuses because there's ways to get music out here. Once again, Jordan Lucas is not signed to anybody.
I feel like he needs to take a Tiger approach and really put the shit on his back himself. Because you know when Tiger was with Young Money, they wasn't pushing the button.
At all.
He went and did it himself. So yes, Wale definitely needs to do that.
And that's what I want because I know you can do it.
Yeah, like, I get that 100%.
It's like this. He's the Markelle Fultz of the hip-hop game. It's like, nigga, we know you can hoop. But with you being injured, are you going to try to fucking get yourself healthy?
That's what I really want him to do more features with some of the top guys. Because people are looking at the top guys. And they slighting them. They're slighting.
But can he rap with them? And I'm not saying because, like I said, he did a song with Logic. And that was my favorite song up there. And he ripped that
shit. Here's the thing. When Wale, when he rapped next to J. Cole, kills. Even when he was responding to J. Cole, he killed. Like, he...
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, he can, like, when he's put up with the right people, he is killing.
Yeah, that door really ain't shutting. His fat ass just laying on the door. So if it pop back open, just let it be. But yes, that album is good.
But yeah, I fuck with Wale. If it wasn't for Wale, I wouldn't be doing music, honestly.
I mean, I understand that, and he gives people that feeling.
Only because, like, you know, I started doing poetry first. And Wale, I got forced to do a poetry class, so I didn't take it serious. And it wasn't until I started listening to Wale earlier shit, I was like, oh, that's a good transition. I like that. If it wasn't for Wale, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing.
Yeah. What other albums?
Not All Heroes Wear a Cape. That's the Metro Boomin album that came out at the end of the year. I still bump that shit pretty heavily. Metro Boomin album is fire. So that's ending up. That's the end of 18.
Okay.
So
19.
So Metro Boomin.
19. I think I know off the top of my head. We got 2 Chainz.
That's still up there for me.
That right there, that album right there, is probably number one album of the year.
Yes.
That shit, and I still have, the thing that I like about 2 Chainz is the fact you never know what you're going to get. And whatever he gives you, it's a hit. It's amazing.
I'm going to say, a lot of shit up here I don't like.
Let's see, okay, so we got 2 Chainz that was definitely out.
You want me to just name what came out, or do you want to see what I think is top?
You can name them.
Cause we got Boosie dropped the project.
Didn't listen to it.
Me either. Let's see who else we got up here.
Oh, my nigga YG dropped.
We got PNB Rock. I didn't like it like that. Dreezy, I didn't listen to it. Lil Pump. He had like 2 songs I actually did fuck with.
Trippie Redd dropped the album this year, right?
Was it this year or the last year?
It may have been last year.
I think it was the end of last year. He dropped 2 albums last year.
Okay.
Yeah. That's another one.
Yeah.
Let's see what else. Nav dropped Bad Habits. I know you fuck with Nav. I fuck with Nav, but that album wasn't it for me. T-Grizzly, Scriptures. I heard it was good. I haven't listened to it.
He just dropped that about 2 weeks ago, right?
Right.
Yeah, that shit was good. T-Grizzly, if I could compare him to anybody, like, musically, it might be The Game, just his approach, not lyrically, but the way he raps.
The aggressive.
Yeah.
I got you. Tiger dropped Legendary.
Yeah.
If you ask me, if you on the West Coast and you need a fucking playlist for a party, then drop the album. I'm
facts.
Rich the Kid dropped the album.
How the fuck am I forgetting my... Oh, Schoolboy Q dropped.
Yep. Megan Thee Stallion dropped. She's doing a lot. On the fucking charts.
West Side Boogie. West Side.
Yeah, Baby on Baby. The Baby. I didn't like it at first. Certain songs grew on me.
And I'm not gonna lie, I went back and I haven't like went back and listened to the album. I went back and listened to like certain songs.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just like, yo, this shit crazy.
Certain shit grew on me. His last project before that called Blank Blank, I liked that a lot better.
Yeah.
But Baby on Baby is cool. Escape from New York, that's Beast Coast. I feel like that's a strong number 2 out the chains. Might be number 1. I don't know. That's debatable.
I mean,
that's a debatable for me.
It is. If we doing 5, that'd probably be 5.
So would you put that under Confessions of a Dangerous Mind? Logic?
Confessions of a Dangerous Mind. That's the new shit. I'm sorry. That album, it was good, but I don't think that album's going to make my top five. I don't think it's going to make my top five.
I heard a couple songs.
No, it was good. But I would definitely put Beast Coast over there, and I'll put...
Is the Father of a Side in your shit?
Who that?
DJ Khaled shit.
That's a strong for right now. You know what? I might have to put that five and move Beast Coast up to four.
Father of Four. That's Offset.
That would be... I'm going to have to keep that one up in the air. That is a good album. It is a good album.
We got a Dripper Drown by Gunna. There's a couple of joints up there I like. It's not in my top five. The Wizard by Future.
Great. I don't like Future, bro. I don't got nothing to give. I just can't get with that.
Great production. From what I heard, I didn't finish. I've never listened to a whole Future project ever. And this was my first attempt, and I didn't get through it.
Because it all sounds the same, right? And it gets annoying. That's why I just don't even give it that time of day.
Sorry, not sorry. Death Race for Love by Juice WRLD. Had some shit up there that I did like.
Is that the buddy that said he freestyled the whole goddamn album?
Yeah.
That is a good album for a freestyle.
Yeah, I fuck with that. Future dropped another project recently called Save Me. Didn't listen to that shit either. Zoo. My shit right
Zoo? Hey, yo, all right, let's stop playing. Denzel Curry, I said it on this podcast, that album, and I'm constantly listening to it.
I'm gonna be honest. If we're talking about top, my top, and I'm saying not what's best, I'm just saying my favorite.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say Chains number one.
Okay.
Zoo number two.
Okay.
YG number three.
Okay. I'm gonna take the same approach.
Shit. Q won't be number four.
Okay.
And it might be up in the air, Nah, I ain't gonna be no fucking up in the air. Father of Four. I'm gonna be bottom. All
right, I'm gonna give it the offset.
I'm gonna take
the same approach, and I'm gonna go. As you said, your favorite, not necessarily like best. What we feel can definitely win. All right, so one, I'm gonna go YG, of course, biased. Two, I'm gonna go West Side Boogie. And people that don't know, I think the album is called Everything for Sale.
I still haven't listened to it. I'm gonna go listen to it.
Yo, you got to. It's really a smooth ass shit. Like, I literally listen to that shit in the morning going to work, bro. That shit's definitely dope.
Actually, you know what, man? I'm gonna say some shit, and I'm not trying to be biased. I'm gonna take Offset out and put my homegirl shit in there. It is her album. So first album on all platforms. Her name Tesh, and I'm gonna rock her shit extra heavy.
I'm gonna really get. I don't know if she listens to the podcast. I'm on my bullshit. I'm gonna let you know. Like, I've been like, of course I follow you in the whole circle. So me, I'm scrolling and I see the same push for Coming Soon. So like me, I'm kind of sitting back and waiting for it.
But she has a video dropping tomorrow. Okay. And I just finished up shooting her inner visions. So that's coming very soon.
Okay, cool. I'm gonna tune in. I'm gonna definitely rap about it up here. We're gonna give it that. Matter of fact,
I'll come up.
Yeah. She'll come through. That'll definitely be dope. But who I got? Who I say? I said YG. I said Westside Boogie. I got Zoo. I got Chains. And then at five,
got that water.
Oh yeah, I gotta go Schoolboy Q. I don't know why I always forget about Schoolboy Q. I don't know why.
Q is my favorite out of TDE. I know everybody goes straight to Kendrick.
I do. But he definitely like Q. Me, if we were to sit back and list the motherfuckers that I fuck with out of TDE, it's going Kendrick, SZA, Q. And then matter of fact, I'm not gonna lie. It might go Kendrick, J-Rock. Scissor, then Q.
mine go Q, Kendrick, Rock.
I feel you. But I ain't gonna lie, man. Like,
but I'm also like, these are guys that I've listened to coming up.
Exactly.
Like, I've known a lot of people kind of got on J-Rock after Kendrick. I was on J-Rock. No, for people who don't know, J-Rock put out the first album for TDE.
Yeah, he did. I'm trying to figure out the first song that I heard J-Rock.
And he had the, she had the one single with Wayne on it when Wayne was doing Wayne.
This is when I first heard J-Rock. Tyrese had dropped the album. It was an intro. And it was called Welcome Home. And J-Rock was on that shit. And that nigga spazzed.
On his,
it was just his flow up there was just crazy.
Let me tell you how shit is so crazy. On J-Rock's first album is when I first heard Kendrick. He had the hood gon' love it. When Kendrick killed that motherfucker.
Yeah.
But then I didn't know who Kendrick was until right before 09 maybe, right before the freshman cover.
I'm gonna let you know, I got invited to go to Greenville to go see Kendrick Lamar.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, all right, cool, I'll go. And I instantly became a fan right there watching him. And his the way he controlled the crowd, that's the things that I look at when I go see these upcoming artists. I don't care what you're saying. I want to see if you can control the crowd.
Right.
Now, Kendrick first controlled the crowd. Then he came in, and then he ended up rapping. And this was Section 80 time.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, yo, this nigga talking that shit.
And at that time, Q was just his hype man.
And yes.
The crazy thing is, before he was his hype man, going back to what we said earlier, I was a big Tiger fan. Niggas don't know, before Young Money, Tiger had his own shit called GED, Getting Every Dollar. And Q was a part of that. That's how I heard of Q. That was the first time I heard of Q, with Tiger back then.
Man, I mean, I'm just proud of TDE in general, bro. Them boys go get it.
So, I'm just saying, with that being said, this is 09, 2010, around that time?
Yeah.
This is 10 years later, bro.
And we still talk, and they still...
So, this is 10 years of me fucking with those guys. So I can't say anybody that comes after them, I can fuck with, but it's not gonna be as heavy. Cause I grew with it.
Facts.
I saw where it came from and where it is
now.
Like, I mean, I got on Ab Soul maybe a little later, about 2012, 2013.
Soul got me went on that goddamn battle. And I went and listened to, cause the battle with him and D and Daylight, like me at that time, I was big on the damn battle rap shit.
Mm-hmm.
And they had posted up, and I knew who he was, but I just wasn't listening to his music because he's like one of those futuristic, out of this world rappers. Like,
right, and that's what I was like, because I first heard him, I think, was it the outro for Session 80?
Yeah.
And I was like, bro, can spit, but at the time, he reminded me so much of Lupe Fiasco.
Exactly.
And Lupe, and I fuck with Lupe, and you see how, you know, Jay fuck with Lupe.
Yeah.
Jay's my brother, and with him all the time. I was like, nigga, I don't need too many bars flying over my fucking head.
Exactly.
I ain't in no bar fight.
So we just dropped our five that we like. Let's go into the artists that are dropping that we know of, that we are ready for, and what you expect from them. Because me, after what the game just did, I'm ready for the game. I'm ready to see what Chance got. I made a statement last week.
He tweeted the other day that this album will not disappoint. Which was crazy. I was like,
that's exactly
what you said. He's like, it's gonna disappoint.
Exactly. And like I said, man, motherfuckers be listening.
I'm gonna be honest, man. The only album I'm really like, yo, I'm ready for this shit to come right now, is Game. And then
I'm ready for the Dreamville joint. They,
oh, yes, I can't forget about that.
Definitely. My only thing is...
Oh, Isaiah Rashad.
Yes, you sent me that. Well, I seen it, yeah. And then you sent it to me.
And then a week after I sent it to you, this week, he started tweeting about it. Like, he's gearing up to let it go.
I got to get back on the Twitter shit, man.
I just got back on it.
I got to get back on it, man.
He was gearing up, so I do want to see what he got coming. They also said that XXXTentacion, they did put together some music that he had left because he was about to drop another album before he died.
Yeah.
And they were like, they They molded it, got it right, and they are trying to put it out hopefully by the end of this year.
The only thing with the Dreamville joint, they're saying that they haven't sold many artists on this. It's like, how long is this album going to be? How many styles am I getting on this? I feel like just a Dreamville style.
I don't think that's what you're going to get.
Because I feel that way too. But I mean, like, only, I don't want to hear Dreamville and then comes Future. I'm sorry. That's not
their only sound. Because, like, Cole has said a couple times recently that he doesn't want to miss rapping with his peers because he's done so much without them. So this was kind of a time to do that, but with his whole squad.
He's also talking about dropping a solo album again, right?
I know he was.
Because he said that he's working with the, what's the nigga in the dress?
Thug.
Yeah.
But that's for, he's executive producing Thug's album.
Oh, okay. That, okay.
Because they're also, J. Cole's last tour, Thug was headlining. Well, they both were headlining.
Oh, shit. Speaking of, I don't want to go, but, they just put out a lineup out there in Vegas where headlining, it's a weekend joint. Friday, I think, is J. Cole. He got his Dreamville niggas. Saturday is Travis Scott. And Sunday is Kendrick. And Kendrick got the TDE niggas. So, I mean, I done seen TDE. I done seen Dreamville. I don't get her to go see Travis Scott. But if y'all, like, take y'all time out and just go look at the damn lineup.
No, I saw it. That shit crazy.
That shit is crazy. That shit is insane. I would love to go see that.
There is one session that I saw Dreamville had, and they have been talking about it since the freshman cover last year. One collab I do want to see is J.I.D. and Ski Master Slump Guy. I don't know how the fuck that's going to sound, but I got to hear it.
I got to get into dude, because everybody keep talking about Ski Master Slump Guy. I mean, like, what is it something that I don't know?
I personally will say that out of the new guys that he came out with, he had the best flow, period. Like, the way he approaches the beat.
He wasn't on this year's, but he was on last year's. Last year. All right.
I thought he had the best flow, and he rapped, like, with the newer guys. The little niggas.
Yeah.
He had the best flow out of them, and he don't use auto-tune.
I'm gonna have to check him out. Where are you from?
He's from Florida.
Okay.
He came out with X.
Okay, I didn't know that. Okay, so I probably have heard dude.
He came out with X, Denzel Curry, all of them are Florida niggas.
And you say your man better than Denzel?
No, I didn't say that.
Okay. Anything else?
I can see in certain songs on Taboo, not Zoo, but the other.
Taboo.
In certain songs, I was like, he got that from Ski. He got that from Ski, bro.
Word.
The Ski Mask, niggas like us who watch the 90 cartoon and shit like that, you gonna catch every bar that Ski Mask throw. Because he got so many shit, bro.
Man, I'm gonna check him out. And I said this when we did Up in Smokes that, like,
his album came out last year. I feel like was slept on. I had a lot of people I was telling about it. And they're like, yeah, I just heard it. Shit fire. I was like, y'all sleep, bro. Y'all was sleep.
I'm gonna check him out. I want to shout out Solid, man, because they were supposed to come through. It's all good. They are throwing a pop-up pool party Saturday. Come through. Let me see if I can quickly find his name, address. Oh, shit. I just got a text that my bro is in town. That's what's up. What was I about to do? Oh, my bad.
While you finding that, I do want to say Ski Mask doesn't do a lot of serious music. Well, he hasn't done any serious music, for real. But he has an album he said he's working on where he's doing all serious shit. Which has been something I was like, yo, the flow that he has, I want to hear it with real content. And he said he's working on an album where he's getting like Lauryn Hill and all. Like, he's like, yeah, I'm doing like a real content based project. Then I'm going to get back on my bullshit. So I was like, yo, I want to hear that.
Hey, yo, so the Solid pop up, the pool party is going to be this Saturday. 1100 Carrington Park Circle, that's Mooresville, North Carolina.
Is that up there by Crabtree?
Yeah, further down. Yeah.
Yeah, that's where the fuck I was just at.
Word.
Hell yeah. Where I'm about to go back.
Oh, shit. Damn, my little bro just hit me up. We about to end this shit, yo. Go ahead.
Let me know what it is. Follow me at PoeVision, P-O-E underscore Vision. You know, we got a lot of shit coming, baby. I can't even get into it all. We got a lot of shit coming. Shout out to Saga. That's the label that I'm fucking with right now. Doing some shit with. Jump Off Studios. Good company. And just, nigga, y'all just wait on it.
Hey, man. Focus, man. I'm dead ass, man. I was in the sunken place, man. I was. But me thinking the way that I'm thinking, I keep telling y'all that, yo, I'm spending money on LLCs. I'm not bullshitting. I'm reading more than I've ever fucking read in my damn life, and I don't even like reading. Like, on God, bro, I am so focused. I got my hustle mentality back. I hope that the homie don't get mad, because I'm coming through, and I'm definitely hustling. You know what I'm saying? I'm focused. I got some things in the works. And with this podcast, we still moving. Things is coming. Y'all just stay fucking tuned, man.
Let me throw this out here. There's a group that we do fucking out of the studio label shit we got going on. There's one group just made it to K97.5. They got some shit in rotation now as of 2 days ago. So shout out to BBO.
They got this shit. Shout out, man. Everybody just keep hustling, keep grinding, man. And man, you gotta start letting me know about these niggas. I mean, if they trash, I'll tell them they trash. But I'm saying, you know what I'm saying? Just, you know what I'm saying? Help me, help them, me help, you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, I mean, you know bro, how I feel about my shit, but bro, at the same time,
so busy that I do not, outside of posting shit on Instagram for the shit that I do, I do not use my fucking phone.
Me neither, bro. I only use, like, dog, like I said, I've been doing the most of my phone, like, these last few months, bro. Just literally just reading up on everything.
Like outside
shit, licensing, all types of shit.
Outside of, like, putting shit together to do business shit, like, if we're not talking business or, linking to do something, I am not. Bro, my cousin kept hitting me like, yo, you busy? I'm like, I'm at a meeting. What's good? He didn't reply. Hit me the next day. Bro, you busy? I'm in a meeting. What's good? I kept telling myself, I'm gonna call him back. But then I'd be so busy that I forget.
Man.
Finally called him back days later. I was like, bro, you good? What do you need? He's like, bro, I forgot. My bad, bro.
I mean, like, yo, nah, it's no reason to apologize, bro. We out here, we focused, man. We trying to make something out of nothing, dog. And it's the fact that we like doing what the hell we doing. And me, when I try to push this to other people, and I'm letting it be known right here, that if you are not on the same mindset that I'm on, I'm not fucking with you.
And I need people, like, really look at my Instagram, like, really go watch my stories and shit. I know sometimes I'll be out there ranting about some bullshit, but, like, I put out everything that I'm doing. Like, I'll show what I'm doing as I do it. Cause a lot of people start coming like, yo, look like you just be having fun, y'all be drinking, y'all be
no, shit.
Bro, we have fun while we do what we do, but it's a lot of work. There's a lot of money put into this. It's a lot of shit. Bro, do you know the niggas I'm fucking with now? We got sponsors now, bro. You feel me? Dude, that don't mean we just having fun.
Yeah,
niggas facts. See what we doing.
Facts. Oh, we got sponsors. Hey, it's your boy Trendsetter Press, man. Y'all know where to follow me at, man. Trendsetter underscore press. That's TrendsetterPress _press, man. Appreciate y'all tuning in. We out. You heard me?